The TV Workshop series is produced and directed by students enrolled in the telecasting program at the Milwaukee Area Technical College.
Learn more about one of your favorite local bands? For the next half hour, we've got Voot Warnings coming at you. So don't touch that remote. Sit back and strap yourself in. The Rock of Milwaukee is coming up next. Hi, and welcome to The Rock of Milwaukee. I'm your host, Dale Kaminsky. The Rock of Milwaukee is a show dedicated to bringing you information and music from your favorite local bands. Tonight's show is no exception. We'll spend the next half hour with the band Voot Warnings. We'll show you a couple of videos, an interview with Voot himself, and later the band will be here to play some live stuff. Now, Voot has been a musician around the Milwaukee scene since the late 70s, playing with many different bands. His latest venture, Voot Warnings, is a project involving himself and a few friends he has played with over the years. His music and songwriting thrives on paradox, on a tension between laughter and tears. His nastiest lyrics are sometimes set to his most compassionate music. The humor of his characterizations often opens a dimension of bewildering sadness and dismay. Warnings has always had an ear for hooks, snappy melodies, and cutting choruses. All the elements of rock and roll at its finest are present on his first album, Platinum, which surveys some of the best of his pointedly twisted songwriting. Let's take a look at the wackiness that is Voot Warnings.
Yeah. just read a comic book. I just read a comic book. I just read a comic book.
Welcome back. That tune was called Crippled Mentals, a song about comic books. As you can see, Voot as a frontman has an extravagant personality, one that changes from week to week, show to show. We had a chance to talk one-on-one with Voot during a recent recording session, and he spoke about the band, a new record, and some other things. Let's take a look.
My bass player, Steve Schrank, sometimes known as Billy, he's been playing with me for like a couple of years, and I'd probably say he's like the most recent person I've been playing with, and I've been playing with him for about 3 or 4 years. Drummer Victor D'Amici, he was in the Gothics, and that was since about 1988. I've been playing with him pretty nonstop. He's a great drummer. Yeah, actually, he was in the Lubricants too for a short time, and he used to insist that they pay him before he'd go out and play with them. Tim Otis Taylor, he's a god. Not quite in Brian Ritchie status. Now he's been in the Ghostly Trio, and I've played with bands that he's been in since 1984. I had a big band with a whole bunch of horns called, what was the name of that band? Battle of the Super Eagles, or sometimes a Galaxy of Stars, or sometimes we called ourselves Washed Up Hazen. Jeff's been playing for years and years with like all these various nightclub people. He plays bass, he plays piano, he plays cello, he plays anything with the string on it. If he wasn't such a coward and was in here, he could like tell you what bands he's been playing with lately, but. Just our friendship had a lot to do with it, and like we're real confident, and everybody likes the songs and material, and I, like I said, I've been playing with all these people for so long. There's just a certain familiarity and comfort that works into that. Jesus Christ is my wife. I might like to make a living. That's basically, if that would happen, I'd be happy about everything else. I mean, I'll shoot higher, but that's all I really want. He's so blonde, he's golden. What do you do when your fate is a blush? And he ain't gonna die for your sin. This is my probably my fifth or sixth recording. There's about four recordings with Gothics. Actually, there's a solo of My Mother Still Likes Me with on a compilation album. I think that's the first thing I had that was actually released. Couple of singles by the Gothics, Richie's Back in Town, and Nice. We had a 10-inch called Monsters, and we're on a compilation album doing a song called The Quest. The first recording we did platinum was basically a history of Boot Warning's greatest hits that had different songs with personnel would change every song, whereas this thing is going to feature more the band that I'm playing with now on like every track, and the sound that we've developed as a band as opposed to songs. This is more of a band album. I thought if I brought in Brian Ritchie, he'd give me like a different perspective on, you know, some things that I wouldn't think of, and I thought of songs where I thought he'd have a better ear for them, and I'm so close to him all the time. It helps to have someone outside your whatever I'm trying to say. Well, actually, we just incorporated. We're a limited liability company. And there's two partners, Steve Johnson and Dale Kaminsky, in the project with me. And what we're trying to do is just promote local music and get out on the internet and just try to give it the blitz and see what we can do.
Well, that was Voot in his own words, talking about the band, among other things. Voot makes his show very interesting to watch because you never know what he's going to do or who he's going to be on stage. We caught up with the band a few weeks ago at Shank Hall and put together a little video using the live footage that was shot that night. Here's Object of My Lust. Check it out.
Sorry.
We're back. And like I told you at the start of the program, the band is here to play a little tune for us. Thanks for bringing the band down today, Vuk.
Thanks for having us, Rockindale.
What tune is this we're going to hear?
This is a song called One Car Funeral.
Is there anything that, like background or anything that you could tell us about the tune before you start?
Yeah, it was originally written as a punk rock song. It's a song about someone who dies and nobody cares.
All right, well, let's get to it. Here's Voot Warnings with One Car Funeral.
Take
Great food.
Thank you.
Mind if I ask you just a few questions?
Sure, go ahead.
What influences your stage appearance usually? We've seen tonight that, you know, you've dressed pretty wild in all of these various videos. Is there anything that's rhyme or reason to the way you dress?
It kind of depends what mood I'm in, like about an hour before I do it and what I grab out of the closet. And I try to not like look the same exact way twice, kind of like a snowflake.
That's great. I noticed in the band there's some unique instrumentation with the slide and the cello. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, yeah, part of the thing behind this band is I just didn't want the same old, you know, two guitars and a bassist and a drummer kind of thing, and like put a little different twist on the into the rock idea, and just more instrumentation and make it more rounded, I guess.
You seem to be kind of a mainstay in that River West music scene. Were there any particular bars or any particular stories you could tell us about that kind of part of our Milwaukee scene?
Well, other than to pay homage to our god, Steve Johnson, the owner of the Uptowner, I think I'm a mainstay in that scene because I've lived there for so long, kind of. It's like...
Yeah, there's been some great shows at the Uptowner, that's for sure.
And then Quarters, which closed down, unfortunately, that was a great place. And
yeah.
Who else will be mad if I don't plug them?
So,
sorry.
You're working on this new record now. There's some kind of famous producers that are helping out. Could you tell us a little bit about those guys?
Oh, yeah. Brian Ritchie from the Violent Femmes is producing some songs with me. And John Frankovic from Plastikland is also producing some songs in the studio.
Yeah, Plastikland, that's a blast from the past, huh?
Yeah. And it's recorded at Bobby Friedman's Sound Studio. There's a plug I'll get in there.
That's cool. So what are your plans in the upcoming months?
Well, I'm going to be on TV. Hi, Mom.
Did you want to introduce the guys in the band?
Yeah, on sliders, Tim Taylor. On bass, Steve Schrank. Cello, Jeff Chase. And bongos, Victor D'Amici. Usually plays drums.
Well, thanks a lot for joining us tonight. Do you got another song for us to go out on?
Sure.
What's this one called?
This one is called, what song are we doing again, guys? My Mother. My Mother Still Likes Me.
All right, Voot Warnings with My Mother Still Likes Me.
My sister.